Hello, Manson.
Welcome to episode 11 of Trojan TV.
I'm Brianna.
And I'm Allie.
This episode was created completely remotely.
Yeah, the Zoom thing is kind of cool. I feel like I can almost give you a high five.
We nailed that. How about a hug?
Thanks, Brianna. Say, how are you surviving right now?
I will survive.
Hey. That reminds me of a song Miss Sorensen wrote and the teacher sang. Let's watch it.
Yeah, let's do it.
At first I was afraid, I was petrified, just thinking I could never teach without you by my side.
But then I spent so many nights thinking how to teach online. So I wrote this song to tell you how to get along.
Please wear your mask from 10 to 8. And then please log in on Outlook to do your work on cyberspace.
You need to set your alarm clock. You gotta Zoom at 8:30. If you stay in your pajamas, they will laugh, I guarantee.
Go on now, go. Lock down your doors. Just turn around now. You can't be out there anymore.
Go back inside your house and learn how to log divide. And when teachers call on you, please respond and do not hide.
Oh, no, not I.
Oh, as long as we know how to Zoom, I know that we will thrive.
You've got all this time to learn, but it's your friends you really miss.
So we'll survive. We'll survive.
Everything is canceled and it breaks your heart, except for math and science, English, history, gym, and art.
You spent oh so many nights feeling sorry for yourself. You used to cry,
but now you hold your head up high.
And you agree, we will get through. You are a chained up little person like inside a zoo.
So we felt like dropping in to sing this MP3. So we can remove a little sadness and add a little glee.
Go on now, go. Lock down your doors. Just turn around now. You can't be out there anymore.
Go back inside your house
and learn to log divide.
And when teachers call you, please respond and do not hide.
Oh, not I. I will survive.
As long as we know how to Zoom, I know we will survive.
You've got all this time to learn. It's your friends you really miss, but we'll survive. We will survive.
Well, that was something else.
Who knew our teachers were such talented singers and dancers?
Check out my dance moves.
Wow, that's sick. Check out mine.
Well, enough of that. Let's head to our last segment, which is a message from the administration.
I hear they do a TikTok dance at the end.
That can't possibly be true.
Well, we'll have to wait and find out.
Then let's roll that clip.
Hello, Manson students. We hope you're doing well during this unprecedented time.
We miss each and every one of you.
But we are so proud of the work you're doing at home.
We know this is a stressful time for students, families, and staff.
But we're all in this together, and we will make it through.
Although we want you to focus on learning, we also want you to prioritize your health. For example, for the first month of the virus, I gained 10 pounds, but now I've found my bike and I'm going to be riding my bike every day.
I've been using this gift of time and have scheduled a 4-mile run in every morning.
And I quit sleeping in and am now scheduling exercise every morning.
And I've been doing American Ninja Warrior courses with my kids.
Geez, Ben, you're making me look soft. I'm going on daily walks with mine.
We also want you to know that we're doing everything we can to help you continue learning at home.
At the elementary school, teachers are checking in each week with their students, and they're updating their home learning page at manson.org. And we're working with the blended learning with packets and with online learning opportunities.
At the middle school, your teachers are checking in with you daily through email, through Instagram, or other social media. They are posting assignments for you on Teams. They are making YouTube videos to provide new instruction for you. And we are currently planning some awesome connections for you coming up this next month.
And at the high school, your teachers are checking in with you and getting lessons to you in a lot of different platforms. Make sure you check your emails because that's where a lot of your information is coming from. But remember, school is still happening and you are still earning credits at the high school and you're earning credits towards graduation, seniors.
And of course, we have a special message for our seniors and student athletes.
Student athletes, I was so glad to see so many people come out in support of our 2020 senior athletes and when we did the field lighting last Friday. And we have some other things coming up for you because we know it's hard to miss out on the spring season. We're hoping to plan upcoming games against alumni so people can have a senior night game. Those may not happen till the end of June, but we're hoping to squeeze them in. So keep watching the Facebook page and the different resources for some upcoming things and keep working out. I've seen a number of you out there running or hitting the track. Do it with social distancing, but it's great to stay in shape and be ready for when that opportunity comes.
And seniors, graduating class of 2020, we really know how much this is impacting you and really has put quite a negative spin on your what's supposed to be one of the greatest years of your life. So we are really working to try and do some neat things for you this spring. We've got a team at the high school that's working on reaching out to every senior and developing a graduation plan with you one-to-one. We also have a group of staff members who are working on what could graduation ceremony look like in this social distancing world? And what other neat senior opportunities can we do? So we want you to know we're thinking of you, we're planning, and we'll be in touch real soon to talk about how each of you are still going to graduate and move on to a great life.
Now, because we're so old and wise, we have some advice to help you get through this time.
As you are navigating the remainder of April, May, and June, make sure that you're taking time to set up a routine and schedule that is going to work for you. That includes any time you need to work, any time that you are helping provide childcare for your family, time to do homework, time to connect with your teacher, time for your own self-care, if that's exercising, going for a walk, getting outside. But setting up a routine that you can follow consistently Monday through Friday is going to help you through the end of this term.
And during this time, not only just thinking about yourself, take some time to think beyond yourself. Think about how you can help or support or encourage your friends or your family or your community while still social distancing. Maybe it's just a quick message or a phone call to grandma and grandpa saying hi. But think beyond yourself and think about how you can serve.
And don't forget to connect. We have all kinds of ways we can connect in today's world, and your generation is even better at it than us. So use those tools to make sure you're checking in with your friends, working together to work on projects or schoolwork, but be creative in how you do it and make sure that you don't lose the connectedness that you need.
And my advice is that you remove that annoying TikTok app from your phones.
Wait, I love TikTok.
TikTok.
Yeah, TikTok. I like TikTok.
Don't do that.
Jeez.
Thanks for watching episode 11 of Trojan TV.
We'll be back soon to highlight our seniors and let them know how much we appreciate them.
That sounds great.
Until then, Manson, stay strong. We miss you.
Thank you.